Yahoo, but there was the Cohen, those were inspired by Rebbetzin in America. Shira Shapiro says the mother Shlomi Sacha, Gail as the captain, many of the parents, which is Shabbat Yosef, Shabba, and then the Moshe Yezer Batani. Peshabat Yitzhak Alei Tzipora, Yisu Ben Yoram, Moshe Yosef Batani. Rexford friends of Gladys Sherman, Gutta Bartnick, the Klein and friends of Judith Klein, Yehudit Tzvi Chaim, Marshron in memory of her husband, Ravi Raphael Ben Oren. Friends and family of Arthur Ritholtz, Mordechai Yehuda Ben Barclay Ben Oren. Friends and film Superbesta, Shraga Ben Dov. Friends of Marvin Weinstein, Mordechai Ozer Ben Yisrael Ahuron. Sarah Alpert in memory of her husband, Rav Tzvi Ripper Ben Oren. A month of learning by Andrea and Ed Bilney, in memory of her mother, 20th Yorkshire, Ed and Sarah Bunch-Linson. Josh and Carol Sanborn, in memory father, Shmuel Akaroff, and his mother, Kian Basari. Sharon and Jerry Glassman, in memory of her father, Eliezer Ben Nissen Halev, David and Henry Blumblatt, in memory of his mother, Ezra Kevin Bud Moshe. Avi Groberg, in memory of his mother, Rosa Bud Yitzchak. Mayor and Sarah Brevin, Michael and Golda Brevin, in memory of Mayor and Michael's father, Asher Zelig Ben Moshe, and their mother, Bela Bud Ari Melik. Sid Paris, in memory of his father, Chaim Ben Aaron Cohen, and his mother, Louis Bas Tzvi. A week of learning by Brenda and Ed Carver, Sandra and Mari Levine, in memory of Ben Sandy's parents, Yehuda Bar Yaakov Leib, and Betzela Ben Abraham Wood. Phyllis and Jeffrey Solomon, in memory of her father, Menachem Kibbutz.
Mayor Gail and Phil White.
I get down as I would have liked, so I'm just going to go back a little bit. We saw that there was a discussion here. Okay, I'm going to start where the lines start to widen. One, two, three. Eight lines up at the bottom of the page towards the end of the line. Okay? Amar Rav Nachman Bar Yitzchak. Okay? That's the spot. All right? So from there. Okay? So we're going to make these examples. He says, Tarnagolet, right? He's disagreeing with what came earlier at the beginning of the Gemara. Okay? As to how long you had to take care of the animal, under what circumstances. So he says, Tarnagolet. Right? It's kibahema. He argues now that a rooster is similar to a behema gas. Okay? Tanya nami hachi, and we learn as follows. Tarnagolet behema gasa, mitapel behen shema sar chodesh, that the rooster and a large animal, they must be taken care of for 12 months. Right? Shema sar chodesh, mikan ve'elech, and at that point afterwards, some domehum umanitham. Okay, one has the basin, assess the value of the animal, they sell it, okay, and then they would give the founder, if he's got it, the money, okay? Or he can use the money, we'll see what the situation is. Agalim saichim, calves and foals, mutapel behem shloshim yom, that's for 30 days. Mitan ve'elech, some domehum umanitham. Again, after that, assess the value with the money and take Avazim v'tarnigol. We now have African okay, doesn't matter. Okay, Avazim v'tarnigol. Okay, again, we're dealing with the geese and the roosters. Behold, davar shetlo merubam ischalo. Any other animal where the care of the animal is going to exceed the reward the amount of money that the person might be getting. But the pale and slow child, you know, deals with them for 3 days. Okay, so that's where we finished. And the Gemara wants to point out that we've had two different statements on two different comparisons. Kasha, okay? He says, what's the argument? Okay, Egalim Vesayachim, regarding the calves and the foals. Agelim Basayachim, Avazim Batanigolim, okay, again dealing with the ducks and the roosters. Avazim Batanigolim, right, that's our problem, okay, two kashas. Agalim v'sayachim, in regards to the calves and the fawns, right? And what happens there? Agalim v'sayachim, lo kasha. No, there's not a real problem there. Why? Hadaraya, there are those that go out to graze in the pasture, v'hat v'putuma, and there are others that we fatten up, okay, from feed. Right, but if we give fatten them up from feed, and as a result in that case, okay, all right, it's going to cost you more, but in the amount of money that you get may be different. Avazim v'tanegolim, regarding them, the ducks and the roosters, right? Nami lo kasha, also no, ha v'ravavi, ha v'zutvayim. There, if you have a lot, if you only have a few. Okay, now we get to another category. In general, okay, these are animals that you can't work, in a sense, okay, and you still have to feed these animals, okay? Tanu Rabbanan says upright, v'hashivot tolo, and you have to return it to him, based on the pasuk, right? Ra'a he'ach t'shivenu lo. One has to see how is one going to then return to the finder. Namely, we're saying that you can't use, take the value of one animal, okay, in this case the cat, be able to feed other cats, the shiachasatim, okay, or the value of one foal to feed the other foals, okay? So in other words, one can't sell one, okay, in other words, to feed the others, either way. Yes. So what's then, what happens to regards to that money received from the sale of the food, from the sale of the found animal? Rabbi Tafan used to mention. Rabbi Tafan says you can use it. Okay? I can low pleading. Maybe we say at this point they don't argue as we go to the top of that question. All right, 29, right? Ella, okay, except in the situation where you're able to use the animal. If you're not able to use it, even of dog, okay, if it happens if the animal is lost, patur, he's exempt, right? He's exempt from any responsibility. He doesn't have to pay any compensation, is the point, okay? Lema tahabe tiyufta, the Rabbi Yosef. Let's say then this is a proof text, okay, against the view of Rabbi Yosef. Because about the following was said, shomer aveda, okay, if one is, has found a lost object and is holding on to it, right? Rabba amar, right? How is he going to compare it to? Kishomer Hinam, okay, in that case, right? Rav Yosef is the one who said Amar, Kishomer Sachar. No, he compares it to a Shomer Sachar. That's part of their machloket. Amar lach Rav Yosef. Rav Yosef would then go on and clarify. B'gineva ba'aveda, the kuli amar lo plige, the chayav. Okay? We're saying that if, according to Rav Yosef, who says, the individual, the Shomer Aveda, is similar to a Shomer Sachar. There are areas where he is going to be responsible, okay, for this, the loss of the item, okay, in regards to stealing, in regards to loss, that everyone doesn't disagree on it. The Chaya, because he would be obligated for compensation. Ki plige, where are they, where do they argue? Ba'onasim, in regards to when there's a certain accident that occurs vis-a-vis the item. The Sho'el, okay? Why? Because we there say he would be similar to the situation of a borrower in that case. Rabbi Tafon Savar, Sha'arulei Rabbanan, Vishamushet Begavai. Rabbi Tafon Savar, that the rabbis permit, okay, the individual to utilize the, right? Utilize it, right? Okay? Okay, and in that case, okay, he would be similar to the Sho'el, the Rabbi Akiva, whereas Rabbi Akiva Savar lo sharulei rabbanam lishtemushe b'gavai. Okay, that the Rabbi Akiva held that the rabbis did not give permission for the use of that fund. Right? Hilkach lo havi Sho'el alayim, and that therefore a similar status to a borrower is not incumbent upon him. Okay, so what happens? If that's the case, where we saw in their language and said, lefichach, okay, so to speak, okay, therefore, what is that reflecting? The Amar Rabbi Akiva Lamari. Why did he say it even then? Okay, Amar, if you're going to say, Bishlema Geneva Aveda Udaplegi, okay, that in regards to a question, an issue, I'm sorry, of theft or loss, that's where they argue. Hainu de Katani, Rabbi Akiva. Therefore, that would be the reason that Rabbi Akiva would add the word therefore. Omer, lo yishtamesh ben, because he's the one who says you cannot use those funds. Lefichach im avdo, and therefore, if you, with the animal were lost, ain't no chaya, okay, or the money, all right, ain't no chaya ba'afiyutan. He does not have any responsibility to compensate. Sarka da'ata famin, it's possible then I might say, shomer sakar have kederav yosef, okay, that the view of the being like a shomer sakar, a paid watchman, okay, would be similar to the view of Rav Yosef. And in those situations of theft or loss, okay, they would have an obligation to compensate. Kamash Malan comes to teach us, lefichach, but therefore that's why he included the word there. Hashta da'amad, lo yishtamesh b'hem. But now where you have a view that says you cannot use that, then you can't compare him to the individual with a status of a shomer sachar. And he would not be obligated in situations of theft or loss. Okay, if you're going to say regarding theft and loss, the kuli amr lo pligit chaya, that there is no disagreement, okay, in the sages that the person would be obligated to plead the owner seen to show him. So where then do they disagree in regards to an accident vis-a-vis the borrower? So therefore, we still ask them, my lefika, the Rabbi Akiva, what then would be the reason that Rabbi Akiva would use the language of therefore? If that's the case, this is how the Mishnah should have taught it and phrased it. Rabbi Akiva Omer lo yishtamesh bahem. Rabbi Akiva says that one cannot use it. Right? Va'ani yadana. What? Right. Va'ani yadana. We know. Kevan de lo yishtamesh bahem lav sho'el have. Since he cannot use those funds, right, he is not considered similar to a borrower. But Eino Chayev Ba'achriyuta, and therefore he would not be responsible, okay, for any compensation. Lefichach, and therefore the use of the language of Lefichach by Rabbi de Rabbi Akiva, Lamali, okay, why then does he say use that language? Mishum Lefichach de Rabbi Tafon, because Rabbi Tafon also has a therefore statement in his perspective. Okay.
Well, the first
question, okay. It's a stylistic issue as opposed to an actual muckle. Okay. So the disagreement, yes, but right. Could I give them, according to one shot, the disagreement of Rabbi Tafon and Rabbi Akiva is not based on the issue of onus as like a shogeg, but rather, okay, it's based on the question of loss. That's the point. Okay, so what happens here? Rabbi Tafon, ulefichach de Rabbi Tafon amar. So why then have Rabbi Tafon suggests? Why is that? Because he would say this, since the rabbis and Rabbi Tafon permit the individual to use those funds, it's actually like he did use the funds, right? And therefore he is, has the obligation, responsibility, and responsible for the loss. Like the view of Rabba. Okay, one second. A little problem here. He holds okay. So now we're going to see what they're really meaning. Amara, right? He holds the following. Nignivu, when we say that the one would be chayav in a case of theft, what is it? When is it? Belistim is ruim, when there are armed robbers. Okay. Of dough, or when we say that it is loss, what do we mean? Shetav'a sfinato boyam, similar to if a ship was sunk in the ocean during a storm. So what happens? Those are clear examples of either theft or loss, and we would might compare it to those. Amar Rav Yehuda Amar Shmuel says as follows. Halachic to Rabbi Tafon, okay? That the law is like Rabbi Tafon. One, biyad rechava, okay? In a situation, right? That, okay? And what happened? Biyad rechava, okay? I want to translate it, okay? Namely, haba lei hinhu zuze diyame, in a situation where he was holding on to monies that belonged to orphans. Atalakame de Rav Yosef. And what happened was he came before Yosef, Rav Yosef, and asked him to follow him. Amale, he said to him, Mahu lehishtamushe begavai. Is it possible for me to utilize these funds? Amale, he said to him, Hachi amar Rav Yehud, amar Shmuel. This is what Rav Yehuda said in the name of Shmuel. Halacha Rabbi Tafon, that the law is like Rabbi Tafon. However, Antrav Yosef adjudicated in that manner was challenged. Amale Abaye said to him, Allah itma Allah, but wasn't said on this situation. Amar Elbo, Amar Rabbi. And Rab Elbo said the name of Rabbi. Lo Shanu Ella Bidme Aveda. That's only talking about a situation of money's reason being lost object. Why? Because one exerts themselves in terms of the whole process. Of dealing with the animal, etc. Not only that, but he has to go, as we saw in the previous Gemara, to the Eben, and he has to announce, and all of this effort. Okay? So it's a combination of efforts. But in regards to money, okay, that occurs to him. Yes, I understand. Okay, that would be one shot. I had a different shot, that's all. That it was money that after he got back from the due to the lost object. Well, that's the one opinion. Delo Tarachmo. Okay? Delo. You use, no, that's one, but that's only one, but that's one view. Okay, Aval Ma'ot Aveda Delo Tarach Baho, lo, but that money, no. Vahani Kima'ot Aveda Damo. And we're saying that in that case, that is the example of situation where the money, okay, is comparable. Okay? Amar Le, and he said to him, so what happened? Zeal, lo shavku le ashri lav. And Rav Yosef responds, go, I'm not able to give you permission to use the money. Okay? To use that. Okay? Okay, we get now to a new Mishnah. And the new Mishnah, okay, presents a number of situations. So it starts off, Matzah Sfarim. Let's assume one found, I'm going to call it scrolls. Okay? What can one do? Korei Behan Echad B'Shloshim Yom. One should read in the scroll, one individual should read in the scroll once in 30 days. And if he does not know how to read in the scroll, Golalan. He should unroll them. Okay? But only so that he's not learning with that scroll for the very first time. And he cannot have another person learn along with him, because then they might stretch the scroll and tear it. Matzah kasot. Say he finds a garment. What does he do? He must unroll it or shake it out once in 30 days. Okay? And in that case, okay, and hang it or spread it out, okay, as it needs. Okay? But not for his own benefit. If he finds utensils of silver, or of nechoshet, or of copper, mishtamesh b'hen l'tzorchan, he may use them for his own benefit. Aval lo, okay, he can use it, but it's the objects get used. Okay, aval lo l'tzorchan. Okay, but he cannot use it. Clay zahav with clay zechuchit. If it's utensils of gold or utensils of glass, lo yigabahen ad sheyavo Eliyahu, he cannot handle them for an extended period of time until arrives at the island.
So that means that he can never use it.
Never use it, because they're going to, right, because that's the issue. Glass, because he's consuming glass. Okay, matzasak, okupa, okay, if he finds, in this case, a bag or some sort of a container, okay, a basket, v'chol davar she'en darko litol, okay, and we say here that it's, okay, some other. Okay, so it came something that he should not ordinarily pick up, right? Haray zeh lo yitol. In other words, if it's below his dignity of that individual to normally carry that, if he's a chacham and he doesn't normally lift up dirty stuff or certain stuff, okay, and if it's not, that's below his dignity to carry it, he shouldn't even lift it up anymore, okay? So what happens to him? Right, doesn't have an obligation. It's not customarily something. A mashmur, says the Gemara. A motzit tefillin b'shuk. Okay? One who finds tefillin b'shuk reminds me of the joke, the story that Reb Shimon told me. I don't know if you hear that thing. Okay? Right? Some demehem. One assesses their value by money hamla alter, and he puts them aside in another place. Metiv Ravina, and Ravina challenges with the following. Matzas Farim, but we say, okay, that if he finds scrolls, Korei Behem Echad L'Shloshim Yom, that one can read in it, okay, once in 30 days. V'im Eino Yudei L'Kvot, this is our Mishnah, and if he doesn't know how to read, go along, okay, he has to, okay, roll it, unroll it. Right, so this is very important, exactly, see, this is what we base on the idea that if you don't use the Sefer Torah for a certain amount of time, okay, that's the point, okay, Kulilan, okay, and, well, yes, we wrote, okay, some demeyam manicham, okay, but it's saying to assess the value and put it aside, no, we don't do that. So we're trying to compare the statement of our Mishnah regarding scrolls to the issue of the tefillin. Okay?
Scrolls.
Right. Amar Abaye, says Abaye, tefillin be barchavu mishkach shchichah. Okay, so according to Abaye, there's a tefillin factory, okay, called barchavu, okay, where they produce lots and lots of tefillin. As a result, the value of tefillin is less, okay, and so you don't have to worry as much. You don't have to have a hire a scribe to specifically buy for you a pair of tefillin, okay? You can just go to Bar Chavu's, the refactory, and pick yourself up. Okay. So what happens? Sparim Lashkikai, but Sifrei Torah, though it smalls, okay, are not so common. Okay? You've got feeling more available than Sifrei Torah. Don't have a Sefer Torah. Right? Tana Rabban, says Avraham. Shoel Sefer Torah Mechavero, one who borrows a Torah scroll from his neighbor, Harei Zer Lo Yeshivenu Lacher, he's not permitted to loan it to somebody else. Okay? Patcho V'Koreibo, okay, one opens and reads it. U'Bevad Shelo Yomod Bo B'Tchila, but on the condition that he's not doing it for the very first time, and not that another person will be reading it from. Okay, particularly if you're saying one person wants to read from something in Shmot and somebody else is busy trying to read from something in Bamidbar or Devarim. Okay, they pull the concern that they'll pull the Sefer Torah in different directions and it's going to And likewise, if one, I'm going to use the word deposits for the time being, okay, a sefer Torah by a kohen, golilo kol shnei maser cholik, he's expected to roll it once every 12 months. Potcho v'korebo. Okay, that's when he opens it and reads in it. Im b'shvilo potcho asur. But if he simply is doing it for his own benefit, okay, it's not permitted. Now, shmachus,
but you can't play it.
Okay? Right. In other words, they would use it for learning as opposed to, okay, for ritual purposes. Okay? So, what's the case? Sumachus as a song. Bechadash. Okay, we're talking about a new scroll. Shloshim Yom, once every 30 days. B'yashan, if it's an older scroll, Shnei Masar Chodesh, there we're talking about once in 12 months. Now, Rabbi Elazar ben Yaakov says as follows, Echad Zeh, it doesn't matter if it's a new scroll or an old scroll. Okay, what do we say? Okay, Shnei Masar Chodesh, it's once in 12 months. Amama. So now we come back to look at what was said previously in the Gemara. Hashoel said, Torah Mechavelo, Areze lo yeshilenu la'acher. One borrows a Torah scroll from another, cannot lend it to somebody else. Ma'i iriye sefer Torah. Why are we specifically talking dafka about a sefer Torah? Afilu kol milei nami. Okay, anything else? Right, that's real. The Amar Rabbi Shimon ben Lakish, as said by Reish Lakish, Khan Shatana Rabbi, and that Rebbe taught the following, okay? En Hashoel Rashai LaHashim, that one who borrows something is not permitted then to loan it out. Furthermore, Ve'en HaSocher Rashai LaHaskir, you can't sublet, in a sense. All right, that's the position. Right? Sefer Torah, it's the Rechai. Mahudetein. Okay, with Sefer Torah, we had to specifically spell it out. Okay, why then? What are you trying to tell us? Right? Is it that appropriate that normally a person feels good about fulfilling the mitzvah with his property? And shouldn't we perhaps argue, therefore, that that would be acceptable? That land of right, that's acceptable. Kamash Malan comes to teach us that that's not the case. Okay. We said, Patcho v'choreo, that he can open it and read in it. Isn't that obvious, right? The Elamai Shai Lelamina. For what other reason would he borrow it? Seifa, it's the Rechon. Now we need it for the end part of our statement, of our mind. Okay, that's why it was new. Okay, so he realizes he's not learning from it for the very first time. And likewise, somebody who deposits a sefer Torah by a neighbor, by his name, one should roll it every once every 12 months. Call the Karembo and to reopen it and read it. Maya Vita Tengabe. Okay, so what is the advantage of doing this thing? But two, and furthermore, Im Bishvilo Pako, we said that if he does it simply for himself, a sword that it's forbidden. Ha, but what? Amarta Pako Vakorembo. But you say, on the other hand, that he can open it and read from it. It seems to be a contradiction. Hachikama. This is what we're trying to say. Im kashahu galalo, if when on the occasion that he's rolling it, potcho v'korebo, he opens it, looks inside it, and reads it at that point, right? Mutar, that's permitted. Im bishvilo, okay, potcho, asur, but if he simply stam, opens it, okay, to look inside, right, that's forbidden. Simach was omer, according to Simchat, Simachos, Bechodesh Shloshim Yom. Okay? Right? Bechadash, I'm sorry, Shloshim Yom. If it's a new scroll, once 30 days. Biashan Shneimusar Chodesh. If it's an older scroll, okay, once in 12 months. Rabbi Eliezer ben Yaakov Omer, he says, Echad zeh ve'echad zeh, Shneimusar Chodesh. Regardless if it's a new scroll or an old scroll, once in 12 months. Rabbi Eliezer ben Yaakov, Hainu Tana Kama. Therefore, that seems to be the same view as Tana Kama, as our original statement. Ela Ema, I would say. Rabbi Eliezer ben Yaakov Omer, he's saying as follows. Echad zeh, echad zeh, shloshim yom. No, once, whether it's an old scroll or a new scroll, one should roll it once in 30 days. Okay? Right? So what happens? Avat lo yumod bo betchina. But nevertheless, when you say one should not learn from it initially for the first time, and another one should not read along with it. Okay? So now Gemara picks up and raises the following challenge, or minhu. But let's raise a contradiction with the following statement. Lo yikra parasha v'yishna. Lo yikra parasha v'yitagin. We have a brayta that says, one should not read a section, okay, and repeat it or learn it, okay? V'lo yikra bo parasha v'yitagin. Nor should one simply read a section and then, I'll use the word, translate it. V'lo yiftach bo yoter milo shabat apim. Okay, and no, one should open it more than three columns. V'lo yikru bo shlosha b'nei adam b'kerech echad. Nor should you have three people reading it from a single sefer. We'll use sefer as a, okay? Okay? I'm thinking kerech here as case, because if you think of a spire sefer, but sefer is acceptable. Okay? Ha, shnayim kareem. That would imply that two people could read from it at the same time. Amar Abai. Okay? Amar Abai, says Abai, love culture, that's not a problem. Khan, the inyan, here when they're dealing with one topic. Khan, bishne inyanim. On the other hand, when they're dealing with two different areas, two different topics. Matzak sut. Okay? Now we get to another piece from our Mishnah. Okay, he found a garment. The Na'ara Echad Shloshim Yom. One should shake it out or unroll it, okay? Hang it, whatever, okay, once in 30 days. The Memra Dini Ur Ma'aleila. Does this seem to tell us that shaking of the garment or hanging of the garment benefits it? V'ama Rabbi Yochanan. But didn't Rabbi Yochanan tell us? Mi sheyesh lo gardei oman betoch beto. Okay, one who has, garments. One who is a skilled weaver, okay? A professional weaver, okay? Okay, betoch beto, yina eksuto b'chol yom. That he should hang or shake out his garment on a daily basis. Amre, as they say, b'chol yom kashila. Okay, because every day it could become tighter. Okay. Achad
l'shloshim. So is the person obligated to go and hire a skilled weaver?
No. Okay, he's using that as a challenge to say once in 30 days. Because you have an example of somebody who is expected to do it daily. That's the okay? Yeah, sure.
Because it's not good for the young folk. Well, so if I am in this
that.
Okay. I didn't have that chat. Yeah, well, we'll see. But we'll see. That was the original question. Is it beneficial to do it? So that's the argument. Okay. Amrei b'chol yom kasher, echad v'shloshim yom, ma'alemi. That would seem to imply that once in 30 days is beneficial for him. He'd buy it in. But I might ask the following. Lo kash. Maybe here that's not a problem. Ha b'chol, v'ha b'trei. Okay, here we might say it's by one person. Here it's by more than one person. Okay? He buy it in. Or I might ask the following. Say lo kasha. It's not a problem. Ha, biyada. It's one thing if you smooth it or rub it by a hand. Vaha, b'chutra. Here if you do it by a stick, he buy it in. Or I might say lo kasha. It's not a problem. Ha, b'da'amra. Okay? Here, if it's the item is made from wool, ha, b'da'chitana. Here, if the item is made from linen, amar Rabbi Yochanan. Says Rabbi Yochanan the following. Okay? Kasa. Okay? D'charshin, v'lo kasad d'kushrin. Okay? All right? So here he's saying now, a cup that it's like a cup of witch's brew or sorcerer's brew is not like a cup of lukewarm water. Okay, it's v'lo amran ela b'kli matachov, and this was only said in regarding the metal utensil. But if you use a porcelain vessel, okay, clay vessel, there's nothing to it. And regarding metal utensils, also we didn't say that. Because the contents are not boiled. But if the contents were boiled, there's nothing to it. V'lo amran ele delo shada be'tziva. Okay, and we didn't say this, except if one included spices in it. Aval shada be'tziva. But if one puts spices in it, v'lumba, you say there is nothing to it. Okay, we keep going. Amar Rabbi. Va'amar Rabbi Yochanan, this is Rabbi Yochanan, mi she'anich lo aviv ma'ot harbei v'rotse la'avdan. And not sit with them. And I understood not that to be not to be there to supervise. Yilbash b'kli pishtan. When we say that he wears fancy linen clothes, bikatna romita, we're talking about Roman linen, okay? That gets worn out very quickly, right? All right? V'yishtamesh b'kli zechuchit, and when we say he uses expensive white stuff, right? Right? B'zugita chivarta, it's with white, expensive white glass. And that he hires workers and doesn't sit with them, in other words, doesn't supervise them. Targuma, explain it the following. Beture denafish psidaihu. Okay, that what we're saying, okay, that it's basically he's going to lose much of his items, much of his property. Okay, and we'll. All right. And we'll stop right there in the top of Lamed Amud. All right, Michael, you think you're going to do it tomorrow? Yeah. Okay. All right.
Okay.
Have a good day.